Hi guys, I'm Josh and welcome to my channel Video EPPO. You would have already guessed from the title of this video that we are going to be speaking about drill bits, how to use them, how not to use them, and what kind of materials you can use them, and most importantly, how to use them without getting hurt, without spoiling the drill bit itself. Let's get to it. Alright guys, let's begin, and I'm going to begin with a warning. Drilling machines or any power tool for that matter should be handled with caution. These things are running at a really high RPM and they may look small but they do pack a punch. You don't want to get yourself hurt, so exercise caution. The second thing is, whatever I'm about to say in this video is from my own perspective, from a homeowner's perspective. Now what do I mean by that? The workshop that you see here is my man cave. And all of this started because I wanted a hobby that is entirely or drastically different from my regular day job. Over the period of 10 years, the workshop has gotten bigger, the tool collection has grown in size, and in this process, in this journey, I've learned a thing or two, and I'm happy to share that with you. With all of that cleared up, let us dive right in. Now, when we're buying a drill bit, we are buying it for the drilling machine. So the drilling machine in combination with the drill bit and based on the surface where you're going to work with, all of these things are the combination, right? So let us understand the drilling machine first. There are lots of different kinds of drilling machines, but let's talk about the generic ones that can be found in a generic tool closet. This one is the drilling machine with only the drill function. This one has got the hammer drill function, and this one is the impact driver. So what is the difference between all of these three? Now, this has got only the drill function, which means you can use it only on wood or on metal. This one has got the hammer drill function. So if you see here, it's got a hammer function here. You can see, you can slide this lever and it goes into the hammer function. Now, what does that do? So the drill function is to drill, like I said, on wood or on metal. But the hammer function is specifically for concrete and bricks. This one here is an impact driver. What does this do? This is got a tappet function. I'll tell you what that is. For example, if you want to, let's assume that this is your a wall punch, and if you are going to make a hole in the wall, what do? You place it on the wall, you hammer it, and then you twist it a little bit, and you hammer it, and you twist it, and you hammer it, and the process goes on. So that exactly is something that is happening inside this drilling machine. So the drill bit is hitting on the wall, it is removing material from here, and there is a hammer that is hammering in this particular direction. Alright? But on an impact driver, what happens is that, let's assume that you're going to loosen a bolt. So what you do, let's assume that this is a spanner and this is a bolt. What you do is that you place your spanner and you hit sidewise. You give it a little bit of a jerk so that it kind of loosens up, and then it gives you that leverage so that it moves, right? Same thing happens in this particular machine. So when a screw is placed in here, when you're drilling a screw or you're loosening a bolt, there is a tappet inside which hammers in this direction. In this one, it is hammering in this direction. This one, if you hold it like this, it is hammering in this direction or this direction, based on you are tightening it or loosening it. So this is an impact driver, this is a drilling machine, and this is a regular drilling machine. As you may know already, the chuck is the part that holds the drill bit in place. The chuck of this drilling machine has three jaws which grab and hold the drill bit in place. This chuck doesn't need a key to secure the drill bit. You can twist it open, insert the drill bit, and simply tighten it by using your hands, and it will stay in its place. This is the hammer drill I showed you, and it also has a chuck which has three jaws. But it needs a chuck key to tighten it and hold the drill in place. Taking a look at this impact drill, I have this quick release drill bit attachment on my impact drill, which means you can pull it up, place the drill bit and let it go, and the drill bit is going to be in its place. However, it can only adapt to drill bit with hex shanks of a fixed size. Note that a 3-jaw chuck can hold the hex shank drill bits, but the impact driver cannot adapt to the regular circular end drill bits. However, it is possible to use these bits using an adapter chuck with an hex shank. These drill bits are used for wood. The size may vary based on the hole you may drill, but note that they all have a pointed brad. The purpose of this being, it gives precision. If a hole is drilled in the wrong place or slightly offset, unlike other materials, it will be very difficult to close it up without being visible, or may not have the same strength as before. Wood drill bits, like any other drill bit, generate a lot of heat due to friction. Therefore, the drill bits made for wood is made using metal alloys which can withstand this heat.
If not, it will dull faster and may snap while remaining still inside the wood, which is not a great scenario. The metal drill bits don't have a pointed end and are tempered with extra hardness. But to start a hole on a metal surface, we may have to make a divot using a center punch, which gets the drill bit started. They too produce excessive heat while drilling, but this can be counteracted using cutting oil, which absorbs the heat. As a rule of thumb, while drilling on metal surfaces, you will have to drill it significantly slower. Make a note here that these drill bits will not be able to drill through stainless steel directly. The surface where you want to drill must be unhealed using heat treatment, and then you can drill the stainless steel material. Notice that the edges of these metal drill bits are way sharper, and it is important that this sharpness is maintained well. Hence, I would recommend using pure cutting oil and not the one that is mixed with water. Also, it's a good practice to clean the bits before storage. Next, let us look at the concrete drill bits. Most of the drilling action of the concrete drill bit happens at the tip and is aggravated by the hammering action of the hammer drill. For stubborn walls, we can use water to keep the drill bits cool, and they are generally made with metal alloys that usually don't rust easily. Now there is this question whether these drill bits can be used on ceramic tiles. Yes, but we will have to turn down the hammer drill function. We start by drilling only using the drill function, and once we cross the depth threshold of the tile, we can switch to the hammer drill function. The drilling machine and the drill bit has to be kept steady at a proper angle all the time while drilling on a ceramic tile. If you are looking for drill bits that are dedicated only for ceramic tiles, then go for a ceramic drill bit. These drill bits can drill through glass and ceramic tiles. In my experience, I found that these drill bits have better precision and are much more faster. However, the process of using these drill bits remain the same. We start with the drill function, and after crossing the depth threshold of the tile, we can then switch to the hammer function. At any point when we notice the drill bit getting hotter due to friction, we can always add water and cool it down. Now that we have covered the basics, let us look at how to make larger holes. For wood, the cheapest, easiest, crudest, and the most aggressive drill bits would be these spade bits. Note that they are not meant for precise holes. These bits are merciless and gouge material, and they are mostly used for making holes through and through. The brad here on the tip is not to let this guy sway too much and keep the play within permissible range. Also, drilling to a certain depth won't work in some cases or in most cases because the brad tip also drills a hole. To counter this, especially if you need precise holes and also drill at a certain depth, we may want to use a Forstner bit. These bits are accurate and they remove material by shaving off a thin layer at a time. You can also drill to a certain depth in case you need to. This Forstner bit is designed specifically to make holes for the hinges. It has a flange that stops the bit from going any further, and you always get a consistent depth. But with both of these drill bits, the material we remove gets shredded. But if you, for some reason, want the inside round pieces you cut, then you can go for drill bits like these. You can always make holes with these, but the depth would largely depend on the depth of the drill bit itself. If you have an option to flip the workpiece or reach it from the other side, you could also double the depth of the hole. I found this drill bit online, and it is also used to make large holes, but you need to align its two arms at equal distance. If not done correctly, it vibrates a lot, even on a drill press. I found it too dangerous and aggressive, and I don't use it. As for metal, I've never seen the Forstner kind of drill bit to drill to a certain depth on metal. They probably use milling machines to achieve that. But for making larger holes, I have a few drill bits. This one is called the step drill bit. As you can see, it will drill holes in incremental steps, and therefore the name step drill bit. The largest hole that the step drill bit I have can make is 32mm in diameter. We also have drill bits like this, which is very similar to its wood counterpart. They come in various sizes, but again the depth of the cut will depend on the depth of the drill bit itself. On a side note, bits like these can be quite handy to make custom washers with scrap metal. Similarly, making a hole in concrete and granite stones is made possible using diamond studded drill bits. I've not used them, so I would not be able to tell much about it, but I guess you get the point. Next, let us say that you want the screw head to sit flush with the surface of the material. Let's say you don't want it to protrude out from the surface. In cases like these, you may need to countersink the hole depending on the screw head. I have these bits which have a countersink and a depth stopper. We can adjust the depth according to the size of the screw and the depth of the countersink as well. Likewise, for metal, I have these countersink bits. These have to be used after we make the hole using a metal drill bit. This is a self-centering drill bit. These drill bits may look like a fancy addition, but believe me, these are really handy. These bits can be quite useful when you want the holes to be exactly where you want them to be and you don't want to waste a lot of time in measurements. I faced a lot of problems while fitting the hinges. One hole pivots, then the whole alignment goes for a toss. These bits will help you avoid all of that. Drill bits can be chosen based on the size of the hole in the workpiece and the screw that has to be attached later. The outer part of the drill bit is aligned with the hole in the workpiece. The drill bit then gives us the pilot hole in the exact center of the workpiece. I've also purchased some of these drill bits which can be used for rasping wood and grinding metal. But in my experience, this is quite time consuming and it does not work well. In summary, these are the variety of drill bits I have and these are quite helpful in getting most of the jobs done in and around the house.
Alright guys, this is the collection of drill bits that I have. Of course, some of them I have as a complete set and some I only have the individual pieces because I was buying them for only those particular projects. And sometimes I did not have the luxury to pick and choose, so I had to buy the complete set because it was available that way. I think we have covered enough subject matter in this video that can be helpful for a homeowner or someone who's getting into DIY for that matter. I hope you like this video. If you do, please do subscribe to my channel Video EPPO and please don't forget to hit that like button. I will see you in my next video. Until then, bye-bye.